President Uhuru Kenyatta traveled to the United Kingdom on Monday morning to attend the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, CHOM. The CHOM is a biennial meeting of leaders from the 53 countries that make up the Commonwealth of Nations. This year's summit is focused on promoting prosperity, safety, sustainability and fairness under the theme Towards a Common Future. The summit brings together at least 5,000 participants from the government, businesses and civil society. The climax of the summit will be the CHOM leaders' retreat at the Windsor Castle on Friday. The retreat is a private meeting of leaders who discuss collaboration on global issues and priorities for the Commonwealth grouping. On the sidelines of the summit, the president will hold other forums with leaders and investors to discuss strengthening diplomatic relations and boosting trade and investment ties with the Commonwealth nations. Among the people Uhuru will meet are Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and Prime Minister Theresa May. The United Kingdom has remained one of Kenya's strongest development partners over the years. Besides trade and diplomacy, security and regional development priorities are also part of the president's agenda for the five-day visit. State House spokesperson Manoa Isipuzia said Uhuru is also scheduled to visit the London Stock Exchange, LSE, for a meeting with investors. He will use the occasion to share areas of investment as envisioned in the country's Big Four agenda. During his address at Chatham House, the president will give details of Kenya's efforts in achieving inclusive economic growth and the positive role the country plays in supporting regional peace among other global issues from a Pan-African perspective. Deputy President William Ruto, Interior Cabinet Secretary Fred Mashangai, Chief of Defense Forces General Samson Wafat and Inspector General of Police Joseph Boynet led other senior government officials in seeing the president off at the JKIA.